start. The petitioner, who retired as a dean in the Faculty of Engineering and Technology of the Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi 1 in January 2011, but who was subsequently re-employed as a professor in the Department of Civil Engineering in the Indian Institute of Technology. Varanasi, up to 30 July 2014, has filed this petition to assail the order dated 26 April 2014, by which he was informed by the institute that, in view of the complaint that was received from a girl student of his department regarding allegation of sexual misconduct, and in view of the report submitted by the woman's grievance cell which examined the complaint, his re-employment as a professor in the institute stands discontinued with immediate effect. Para, it transpires from the records of the writ petition that after the petitioner retired as a dean in the Faculty of Engineering and Technology of the university in the month of January 2011, he applied for re-employment. A letter dated 20 July 2012 was sent to the petitioner by the university, informing his that the Executive Council of the university in its meeting held on 29 July 2012 had been pleased to re-employ him as a professor, and that if he was willing to accept the offer, he could submit his joining report to the director of the institute. The petitioner accepted the terms and conditions stipulated in the order and was deputed to the Department of Civil Engineering of the institute for a period of 1 year, or till the post was filled up on a regular basis before the term of 1 year was come to an end on 30 July 2013. The petitioner moved an application for extension of his re-employment as a professor. It needs to be noted that the erstwhile Institute of Technology of the university became the Indian Institute of Technology, Varanasi, with effect from 29 June 2012 under the provisions of the Institutes of Technology Act 2012, a communication dated 10/11/2013 was sent to the petitioner by the institute extending his re-employment for a further period of 1 year with effect from 30 July 2013 of the existing terms and conditions. The terms of re-employment of the petitioner as a professor in the institute therefore stood extended up to 30 July 2014. Para, Shri Ajit Kumar Singh, Learned Counsel, appearing for the university and the institute, however, submitted that in view of the seriousness of the allegations that had been made against the petitioner by a girl student of his department, which allegations were found to be true by the committee consisting of senior professors of the departments of the institute, the re-employment of the petitioner as a professor in the Department of Civil Engineering was discontinued, and that in such circumstances a detailed inquiry was not required to be held, nor a copy of the report was required to be served on the petitioner. Learned Counsel also submitted that the petitioner was re-employed by the institute for a further period of 1 year with effect from 30 July 2013. Over.